Hey guys, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on whichever time zone you are. So welcome to the Salesforce tutorials. So in this channel, we are going to upload a series of Salesforce tutorials, which will include various features and various other things that you can do in Salesforce. So this video is basically for introduction to Salesforce. What is Salesforce? Salesforce is an on-demand service provider which helps you manage your customer relationships, integration with other systems, and to build your own apps in cloud. The service includes easy to use customizable tool which you can use in creating various apps. Salesforce provides infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, and software as a service. So these are cloud services provided by Salesforce. So Salesforce currently is one of the biggest giant in cloud industry. And they ought to be, as they are providing good services. As compared to other cloud services, Salesforce is 75% more faster in data delivery. So moving to Salesforce architecture, what architecture Salesforce follows? So in the base, it follows multi-tenancy architecture where a server contains various orgs. Like a single server is used by multiple clients. So all the clients are using the same server, but their orgs are isolated to each other. So their data is not mingled and everything is perfect. As a single server is being used by multiple users, so it should be maintained like a single user does not impact services of other clients or other users. So for that, everything is limited in cloud, or we can call in server. So we have every limits we follow. On top of that, we have a complete data model of Salesforce. And on top of that, we have a platform like force.com, which we use to build the application on Salesforce, Heroku platform, which we can use to host various applications irrespective of whichever technology you are working on. Then we have a Fuel platform which is used for emailing on all purposes. Then we have various applications out of the box provided by Salesforce like Communities, Chatter, Work.com, Data.com, Sales Cloud, Service Cloud, Marketing Cloud. Then we have App Exchange. Like in Google, you have your app stores, and in Apple you have Apple Store where you get various applications that you can run on their platform. Similarly, we have App Exchange in our Salesforce from where you can download various apps. Some are free, some are paid depending on your need. So you can download those apps and use on your org. As Salesforce provides a good integration APIs, so you can utilize that for integrating it to backend systems like your ERPs and financial systems, which cannot be brought to cloud. Salesforce is platform independent, that is, it runs on every device which you can name, like your e-watches, your mobiles, your tablet, your laptop, your computers, anything. Salesforce can be integrated with your social networks as well for like single sign-ons and various other functionalities. You can integrate with that also. So overall, Salesforce is a good package. So what features Salesforce provide to business or to the developers which are working on that platform? So it is fast, it is easy, it is open, we can work anyway. It is flexible in the sense you can upgrade your services, you can downgrade your services depending on your needs. It is trusted. Salesforce has a trust.salesforce.com where they show real-time data of what all servers they are using, whether they are down or whether they are up, or when maintenance is scheduled. So all that details are present on that site real-time, so you can see there. And you can see there as well as your security, other securities and content related to that. So what Salesforce does for us when we are working on cloud application? So various infrastructure services, application services, operational services, these all are provided by Salesforce. So we can utilize them to build up our application. Like if we see like on your infrastructure services, so in infrastructure services, it is like network, your storage, operating system, database, app servers, web servers, data centers. So all those things are maintained by Salesforce. Then if you look on application services, so in that security, sharing, integration, customization, web services, APIs, multilingual, these all things are done by, handled by Salesforce. Then if we go on operational services, in operational services, it is like authentication, availability, monitoring, patch management, upgrades, backups. So these all things are also managed by Salesforce. Then what need of our web developers, your Salesforce developers? So our focus is on business logic, which the client demands. Client demands, like I want this type of business flow, business work. So our work is to utilize that platform and focus on the business logic which the client is demanding and provide him the same architecture, same application. So that's great. Like we do not have to focus on everything like security, your hardwares, your initial codings like login, session management and all. So everything that is managed by Salesforce, and we are just focusing on business logic. So it is just removing the repetitive work which in every project or every application it is required. Next, moving to what all products Salesforce offer. So it offers marketing cloud, sales cloud, service cloud, community cloud, analytics cloud, app cloud, and IoT cloud. IoT cloud is Internet of Things. So in marketing cloud, like when you enter into a market to sell something, so first you brand that, first you campaign about that, and then you start in the sales process, like you're converting leads into opportunities and accounts, selling assets, and then providing service to that sold product. So like a client, a customer faces some issue, he raises some case, so everything can be managed using these marketing, sales and service cloud. Then if you want some portal kind of a thing where a customer can check about your products, check about or he can raise an issue regarding a asset which he has purchased and he has some issue and he needs some service help. So these kind of portals can be built using community cloud, like partner portals, customer portals, these all can be built using community cloud. Then we have analytics cloud. Analytics cloud is for, like in general logs, we have reporting and dashboarding facility, but these cannot handle large amount of data. So for that, Salesforce has provided its analytics cloud, which is capable of handling a large amount of data, and it is using wave technology in the background, so it is very fast and helpful. Then we have an app cloud. App cloud is like we do not have any out of the box business model. We just can utilize that platform and build our own apps. Then we have Internet of Things, like IoT cloud. So this cloud is the recent one which Salesforce has launched. So this cloud can be used for building integrated apps like your home automation systems, where you can control your electric or electronic appliances through a cloud platform. So next, moving to Salesforce editions. So there are various editions offered by Salesforce depending on the need of the customer. So they are like customer manager, group, professional, enterprise, performance. So these are different editions depending on your business size, depending on your organization size. You can purchase your org and start working with that. So that is great, something great. So you should get started and try out what are things there in the app cloud. For us as a developer, it is free to dirty our hands and try out things in the cloud in our org. We can create our own developer org free of cost, and we can try out different things what we can do in that org. So you can just go to developer.salesforce.com/signup and just sign up for that, and you are get to go for that. So this video ends here. Thank you for being for viewing this video. Don't forget to subscribe for this channel, as we are going to publish various other videos on different other topics and the latest things which are going on in Salesforce. So we have started with the basics, and then we'll be going forward with creating objects, creating applications, security models, then configurations, customizations, then latest we have Lightning. So we'll be going on Lightning app building and various other features that Salesforce provides. So thank you for being patient. Thank you.